So feedback mechanism is observed in the secretion of hormones. So the hormones are secreted to bring a change. But when the person has to regain his normal position, in such cases, the production of the hormone is controlled. The level of the hormone in the blood is controlled. So this is called as feedback mechanism. We have already discussed in situations like fight or flight. So during that case, when we are scared, in such a state, adrenaline is secreted. So this adrenaline is secreted in that situation, say for example, anger, it's an emotion. So it is caused because of the adrenaline. But the person, when he retains to normal, then it is observed that the level of adrenaline is also comes normal. So the level of a hormone in the blood comes to normal position and the person can regain his normal status. So we have already discussed about that insulin. So when there is large amount of glucose in your food, then insulin is produced. So if the blood, the sugar level in the blood comes to normal, then the production of the insulin is decreased or ceased. So the rate of production of hormone is controlled by depending upon the internal environment. So this is called as feedback mechanism. So when the change is not needed, the production of the hormone is also controlled. I already told that these counteracting hormones are also there, insulin and glucagon. Once the activity, the amount of the glucose is increased in the blood, insulin converts the glucose to glycogen. Once the amount of glucose in the blood is low than the normal, then glycogen, this glucagon hormone converts the glycogen to glucose. In such a way, feedback mechanism is also observed. So the timing and amount of the hormone that is produced is automatically controlled by the feedback mechanism. So there is no involvement of the nervous system in controlling the production of the hormones. So it is inbuilt in our body, the automatic mechanism, which it senses when the levels are high. So the feedback mechanism helps to bring normal. Autonomous nervous system. So autonomous nervous system is the nervous system which controls the involuntary activities. So mostly the medulla oblongata, and autonomous nervous system. These two control the automatic involuntary activities of our body. All the involuntary actions are controlled by this medulla oblongata plus autonomous nervous system. So what is this autonomous nervous system? What it comprised of? So we already discussed that near the spinal cord on the ventral and dorsal side, we find groups of nerve cells called as ganglion, from which pairs of nerves are arised. So this autonomic nervous system, it is comprised of, so here this autonomic nervous system, it is comprised of sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. So this sympathetic nervous system, it is made up of the nerves that are arisen from the ganglion on the either side of the vertebral column, ganglia at vertebral column, plus association neurons. Whereas the parasympathetic nervous system, it is comprised of the nerves that are arising at the brain and in the spinal cord. It is comprised of cranial and spinal nerves. Cranial and spinal nerves. So among this cranial and spinal nerves, there are 31 pairs of spinal nerves and 12 pairs of cranial nerves. 12 pairs of cranial nerves and 31 pairs of spinal nerves together constitute the parasympathetic nervous system. The sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system, they constitute the autonomic nervous system. So this autonomic nervous system and medulla oblongata, they together constitute, they control the involuntary actions or activities of the body.